This is my first visit to Ames. It's a very impressive facility. The scope of work that's happening here is also impressive. What I got out of today was the ability to talk directly to researchers, bypass all the rhetoric that we hear in the media all the time. And it was refreshing to hear the views of the scientists, how they work, the hands-on approach to the research. And then when we got to the sea stimulation laboratories, it was just blew me away. It was amazing at the level of scope of research that's happening here in the facilities. So we're very lucky to have this in North Queensland.
Part of my role here is leading at the Reef 2050 Marine Monitoring Program, the water quality component of that. So that's a program that basically monitors inshore water quality at a variety of sites around the inshore parts of the Great Barrier Reef. So from the Mackay Whitsunday region up to the Barron Daintree region. It's great to have canegrowers come out and visit Ames. They tend to have a good understanding of things like nitrogen and phosphorus, so they're a really good audience to speak with about water quality issues. They're obviously very knowledgeable and they really listen and engage with the water quality science that we're talking about.
I think that was a good discussion that we had, understanding the scale and what drives the change in the inshore reef, what drives change in the mid-shelf reefs, and what drives the change in the outer reef.
That's exactly right. And I think that's where growers need to hear that sort of information, so that we know that there are certain impacts inshore, there's certain impacts midshore, and there's certain impacts on the outer barrier reef. And it's not just all lumped together, so that when we hear a negative impact, it's not that it's the whole reef, it is certain parts of the reef. And we've got to be able to understand how what we do on land, how that may impact past the farm boundary.